We are at the summit on day one of our hike. And it's the highest point I've ever been. So it's kind of exciting for me. We're at 15,400. The view is spectacular, as you can see. It's a cloud. So we hiked, we scrambled. As you can see, there's rocks all around me, and the end was a little scary because we had to scramble. But fun, hard, and we're at the top. And this is the highest I've ever been, which is pretty cool. 15,400. It's hard to breathe.
Taking a break. I'm breathing pretty hard. It was pretty
yeah. Steep over there.
Yeah, direct line.
I was not at.
What are you eating?
No wafers.
Is that the professional hiking food?
I think so.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, it's light, semi-sweet.
That lovely granola, something healthy.
Team Ecuador, we are at the peak of Fuya Fuya. Today's accomplishment, we gained 1,500 feet of vertical elevation in 1 hour and 19 minutes, including our rest break.
Thank you.
have made it to the hut of Cayambe, and I have to tell you, it's rather lovely. It's spectacular. It's really nice. I wasn't expecting it to be this nice. The road getting up here, we all piled into 4x4 trucks, and the road was, well, pretty bumpy. You know the commercials for SUVs where they show like people off-roading? I think they film them here. It was a little like extreme driving, but our driver, Jaime, was amazing. He knows what he's doing. He does it all the time, so I felt safe. I'm taking it all in. We just got in to the hut, and this is, as you can see, pretty spectacular, and oh my gosh. I see the big guy behind me, which is amazing. This is the first glimpse I have had, and I'm pretty excited about it.
W compared to what we stayed in before.
Is it the nicest hut you've been in?
It is the only hut I've been in. So.
You've been in a lot of huts.
I've been in a lot of huts, and this is a really nice one. We're going to have fun.
We are.
Lisa, how do you like the hut?
I love the hut.
I'm like, compared to Rainier, this place is luxurious.
Oh, yeah, compared to Rainier,
this
right?
This is luxurious.
Right. Right.
Alright guys, this is officially probably the only Good video
morning.
That I will take today. Alright, how are you feeling, David?
Oh, after a wonderful night's sleep like that?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Excellent. Rebecca?
Doing great.
Uh-huh. Are you nervous?
Alright, a little nervous, you know.
Yeah?
Gwen?
Are you nervous?
Sure. Always.
Sure. How are you feeling?
Not nervous at all.
Not nervous, right? Liz, you're way back there.
I'm nervous and excited.
Fair enough. He's a happy guy.
Oh, what? Who? What?
You? No. You're good. It's like the only video I'll take today. You ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready. We're doing it. I don't know. I don't think we have a choice at this point. It's go time.
We do actually have a choice.
Good job, Amy.
I don't know.
so yesterday, yeah, we got to near the base of the glacier on Cayambe, and while we were doing that, we had clouds that were lifting up. We started off with a clear, cold evening, and there was a little bit of thunder and light, or not thunder, but lightning in the surrounding clouds kind of out to the south of us. And as we climbed up to the base of the glacier, the clouds lifted and then the lightning began like just encompassing the entire sky.
Yeah, and basically sort of one of those variables is not necessarily a determining factor, but the trend was just decreasing in terms of our weather situation. So, you know, we weren't as concerned when we saw it just off in the distance, but as things started to encircle us more, people are starting to feel static, hair raising on the back of their necks, things like that. And that's when, you know, as those things all add up, they add up to something that's where the risk is not worth continuing to go higher. So,
yeah. And there's no safe place outdoors when you have electrical activity. So best place is indoors, and that's where we headed. The other part is that the cloud could have precipitation and moisture, which it ended up having a lot of snow, wet snow. And so moving higher up at elevations when you're going to get wet only means people are going to get colder and potentially hypothermic. So that's another big factor that we have to mitigate and kind of plan around.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was a difficult decision to have just gotten basically to the base of the glacier before we had to turn around. And yeah, unfortunately, that's what happens in mountaineering.
Here's to conquering the foothills of Cayambe three times.
Cheers.
Cheers. Salud.
Yeah, good. that's enough red flags for us to be, one, concerned about triggering avalanches around us, but also the other variables being we have low visibility. We have terrain traps above and below us. So if we were to continue higher, we'd be traveling through areas where not just the snowpack itself could present a danger of sliding, but also send us somewhere we don't want to be.
Yeah, I think that, you know, when avalanche hazards are like clear and present, we wouldn't have even left the hut. But the fact that we were worried enough about it to stop and do some tests and the stuff that we train on, I think that speaks to like just the initial like kind of hair standing up on the back of some of our necks and just kind of being worried about the slope, especially as we got into the steeper parts and as we started noticing that the snowpack had gone from only about 4 inches of new snow to well over a foot in some places. And so yeah, it's a bummer for sure, but it's the right call. It's the call that we have to make.
What different amounts of pressure, like basically to simulate like what our like footprints are doing and like what us walking on the snow is doing. And so we just kind of, this is the top layer that we're walking on, right? That's not really that concerning because it's nice and sugary, but you see that collapse? Mm-hmm. And so basically you can come in here and we can find the layer that collapsed. And that was 10 like baby taps.
Yeah.
And about, I think I got to 6 taps just from my elbow. And that doesn't mean, that's not that, like that's not that much pressure. And then the other thing, so what we're looking at is the bonds that this layer has with the layer underneath. And so right now we have about a 1-inch slab on top of a nice smooth sugary surface that when we just barely scrape away, we get to another slab and I can just kind of pull that next slab out. And so that's like almost a 2-inch slab. So we got a 1-inch slab on top of like what we could like dust. And then we have a 2-inch slab on top of more dust, right? And so if we are walking in the trail, it's one thing, it's kind of compact, but we're going to be traversing. If you guys look up here, if you look, shine your lights, you see all of these big crevasses. We're going to be moving through there, and all it would take is someone to step out of the trail and the slope to cut away, and then a rope team gets pulled off their feet. And we also have steep slopes above us, so because of the slab, once it gets to a certain angle, the whole slab can cut loose and then come down from on top of us. It's dark out, it's cloudy out. We can't necessarily see how slopes are loaded or what the angles of them are right now. And that's really the concerning factor here.
So you feel pretty sad, but better safe than sorry. Yeah. We turn around on our second rest stop at almost 18,000 feet just because of avalanche conditions.
It's a bummer. I'm disappointed. I'm not going to lie. But it's the highest I've ever been. And again, this is why we're with the best people, because they're not going to let us do something stupid just because we want to. How are you feeling?
I'm bummed. But it's the right decision. We had a new altitude record, right?
Yeah,
so that's something
we did
to celebrate, but I'm feeling strong. Like, I could keep climbing, but I get that it's too risky.
Yeah.
So, but I'm super bummed.
It's a bummer, but we have avalanche conditions. So red flags for avalanche conditions is 12 inches of snow in a 24-hour period. And while we didn't have that down at the hut, we definitely have that up here. And this is where we're currently climbing. So that's a red flag. The other red flag is that we have two different slabs that have built up in a snowpack. You know, a lot of new snow in a really short period of time. And we haven't had a lot of sun on it. You guys, we've all seen the afternoon storms that have been coming in. So it's not like this slope has had a lot of sun to like do the freeze thaw and compress and compact these layers to make them safer to travel on.
And I wouldn't have recognized it without the guides to, you know, see the train and be able to you know, evaluate this, and if without them, you know, I would have just been, you know, it all seems just fine, and it's not so, and it's not worth our risking our lives. So,
new personal high is 17.75, right here, right now. So we can put that on the calendar and build for something else.
All right, how are you feeling?
So obviously a little disappointed. I was feeling pretty good tonight, pretty strong. So that part's disappointing, but this is why I climb with RMI. This is why I climb with the company I do, because I think safety really is first. And so tonight, you know, they say the mountain decides whether you climb or not. And tonight we're not climbing, and I would rather go home alive and unscathed than have a chance to come back. So, you know, now we all have to just come back. Cayambe and Cotopaxi.
So I certainly didn't expect to end the video with me on the rooftop of our hotel in Quito. I had grand plans for us to be high-fiving and jumping around on the summit of Cotopaxi, the sort of cliche ending to any video. But that didn't happen. And I think you could hear in everyone's voice that it was disappointing. I found, after spending 10 days with these people, that most are goal-driven people. I am as well. And so we focus on making the summit. Did we summit? But as I look back and see all the footage and the photos from the last 10 days, I see all the experiences we shared, the culture of Ecuador, the crazy 4x4 rides up mountains, the meals, the laughs. We spent a lot of time talking and feel like we know each other well. So sometimes you hear, as cheesy as it sounds, that the journey is more important than the destination. But I think in this case, it's true. And I know for one, I'll come back. Cotopaxi isn't going anywhere. Cayambe isn't going anywhere. I can still summit those mountains, but I can't recreate all the experiences we had on this trip, and I'm incredibly grateful to have had them.